Greetings. This video is part 2 addressing the claim by Islam that Jesus was a prophet of Islam. One of the Muslim claims is that Jesus declared only one religion, and that is Islam. It is important to know the true history and true story before addressing Islam's offering. In the beginning, God created the heavens and the earth. Genesis 1:1. God revealed himself through the elements of nature and by revealing himself to specific individuals. God walked with Adam and Eve. Adam was not a prophet. Think about it. There was no one for Adam to be a messenger to. God revealed himself to Job and Noah and then Abram. God changed Abram's name to Abraham. The Old Testament, meaning the Torah and Tanakh, contain the history and the message of the prophets. The prophets did several things. The prophets came as messengers or representatives of God. The message they brought would remind people to obey God's revelation. The message they brought would correct various sins the people of God were committing. And see, their message would reveal future events and details of God's plans. D, they would often confirm God's endorsement, working miracles, demonstrating God's participation. Those 4 points are a good guideline to remember evaluating real prophets. A, remind people of God's revelation. B, correct sins being committed. C, foretell future events. D, work miracles as proof. With real prophets from God, the value of prophets was obvious. A real prophet from God could warn a king and protect his kingdom. I imagine there was potential to confuse wise counselors as prophets and seers, wise men. So there were false prophets who also arose. They would say what the king might want to hear, but it was not from God. Jeremiah provides an interesting study of one man from God facing many false prophets. So the message of the prophets came over the course of many, many centuries. The prophecies accumulated in an ever-growing list of details. And that creates an interesting situation, which I'll mention, but is a topic for a whole separate video someday. How do you judge a prophet? You examine his prophecies and whether they come true. But what if his prophecies are for the distant future? That means one could not judge their prophecies while they lived. Like I said, a topic for another video someday. Getting back to it, in the fullness of time, the real and true prophecies would be fulfilled. And they were. The Messiah, the Son of God, the Word of God made flesh, came to his temple and walked among men. The Messiah was sacrificed for the sins of his people, just as the prophets had said he would be. The Messiah established a new covenant that was a blessing to all mankind, as the prophets foretold. And when Messiah had accomplished that portion of the plan, he declared, "It is finished." His death on the cross was the greatest victory in human history. Colossians 2:14, blotting out the handwriting of ordinances that was against us, which was contrary to us, and took it out of the way, nailing it to his cross. And having spoiled principalities and powers, he made a show of them openly, triumphing over them in it by his death on the cross. Had Satan understood the plan of God, Satan would not have crucified Jesus. 1 Corinthians 2:8, none of the rulers of this age understood it, for if they had, they would not have crucified the Lord of glory. So Satan was defeated. Revelation 1:18, I am he that liveth and was dead, and behold, I am alive forevermore. Amen. And have the keys of hell and of death. Not only was Satan defeated, but Jesus took the keys to the front door of hell. But Satan was not dead, was not destroyed. So what is Satan, defeated, stripped of authority, to do? Satan does what Satan's nature directs him to do. He lies. Jesus said Satan is the father of lies. John 8:44, you are of your father the devil, and your will is to do your father's desires. He was a murderer from the beginning and does not stand in the truth, because there is no truth in him. When he lies, he speaks out of his own character, for he is a liar and the father of lies. Satan lies. Satan deceives. Satan is the best deceiver. Satan is the Almacher, the best schemer. And if that sounds familiar, it should. Surah 3:54. But they, the Jews, were deceptive, and Allah was deceptive, for Allah is the best of deceivers. The Quran proudly declares the Allah of the Quran is the best schemer, the best deceiver. It took Satan roughly 600 years to devise a scheme to counter, to attack, to wage jihad against the truth of the fulfilled, completed message of the prophets. To devise a web of lies that would suit his jihad, his war against Yahweh and the God of Abraham's plan. I am about to make a declarative summary statement. The support and evidence and rationale, the indirect proof of the statement, will follow. But I am presenting it this way so you can evaluate the evidence as I go. If you call yourself Muslim, you will not like the statement or the vast number of evidentiary points. I challenge you to be intellectually honest and listen to the points. First, understand the statement and the evidence. Then, your challenge, your struggle, your jihad is to prove it false. Prove it. Not just cry lies like a scared child. But here is the kicker, the damning problem you face. You cannot use the Quran as evidence. You cannot use the Quran to prove the Quran is true. The proof of my statement must be, in some regards, indirect in nature. Because just as one man can never know the true heart or thoughts of another man, 1 Corinthians 2:11, for who among men knows the thoughts of a man except his own spirit within him? So too no one knows the thoughts of God except the Spirit of God. No man, including me, can know the thoughts of Satan, nor would I want to. But intelligent analysis and discernment can derive the most plausible rationale. Arthur Conan Doyle wrote, "Once you eliminate the impossible, whatever remains, no matter how improbable, must be the truth." That is one method of arriving at the truth, to whittle away and eliminate all that is obviously and provably false. A second, more whimsical corollary is the idiom of the duck. If it quacks like a duck and walks like a duck, it must be a duck. So here is the statement. Islam is Satan's jihad of deception and cloud of lies to subvert, confuse, and deny the salvation Jesus provided. Islam was created and exists to deny salvation to as many people as may be compelled or tricked to follow it. That is the statement. And really, it will take more than 3 minutes of video to fully justify and support it. But I will begin to lay out the outline of the support here. If you examine Islam critically, you should notice many strategic, tactical things. Things that, if one were committing an act of deception and subterfuge, would be the obvious approach to use. 1. The only known religions mentioned by name that Islam attacks, Judaism and Christianity. Just a quick example analysis of this aspect. If every religion were true, Satan would need to undermine every religion on earth. Islam does not directly address any specific doctrines of any other religions. By implication, its target is specifically Judaism and Christianity. 2. Islam makes the claim of being related to the two religious faiths. Initially, the claim is kind, but after rejection, the relationship becomes bitter, angry, and murderously hateful. 3. Islam selectively makes claims to the various historical figures of the two religions. Claiming all Jewish prophets were prophets of Islam even before Islam ever existed. Claiming the Jewish Messiah was a prophet of Islam is another impossible claim. 4. Islam selectively claims agreement with one principle of both religions, monotheism. But Islam presents a different central deity. The name and behavior of the deity of Islam is absolutely foreign. 5. Islam makes claims to various doctrines of the two religions. The Ten Commandments are claimed, but only 9 appear in the Quran, and never as a single list. And the command against murder is not to followers of Islam. It is only a mention of God's command to the Jewish people, who, it seems by demonstrated practice, are okay for Islam's followers to murder. 6. Islam makes claims to being a correction of the two religions, correction being a euphemism for change and corruption. And this is where Satan's web of lies begins to change the message of the prophets. Islam selectively references historical events of the two religions and rewrites the history. Islam claims Ishmael was offered for sacrifice by Abraham. Islam mentions the plagues on Egypt, but gets the count and plagues wrong. And critically, Islam claims the crucifixion of Jesus never happened. Remember, the crucifixion was the central event in Satan's defeat. What Satan could not anticipate or prevent, Satan must deny. 8. But Islam denies other core principles and doctrines of both religions. Islam denies the Messiah is the Son of God. Islam denies that God would visit his creation. Islam denies that God even could visit his creation. 9. By denying the crucifixion, Islam denies the sacrifice of the Lamb of God, thereby denying all salvation from God's gift to men. 10. Islam teaches violent intolerance of all who oppose it. Muhammad's message of violent jihad was refined by his success in Medina. After his abysmal original failure in Mecca, gaining less than 200 slaves. 11. Islam teaches murder of those who follow it, learn of its error and deception, and apostate. 12. Islam teaches hatred, oppression, and murder of the followers of the two religions. Sharia law is codified evil, discrimination designed to crush Christians into submission. 13. Islam presents known pagan rituals as its core practices. 14. Islam's teaching requires disregard for all prophets except Muhammad. The message of the prophets must be ignored whenever it differs from Muhammad's Quran. That functionally means only Muhammad's words matter. 15. Islam establishes a tacit virtual partnership between Muhammad and Allah. You cannot be Muslim unless you obey Muhammad in all things. You must obey Muhammad in every regard as you obey the Allah he claimed to speak for. Islam is therefore actually submission to the will of Allah and Muhammad. 16. Islam's teaching results in allegiance to Muhammad over allegiance to the God of the Torah. 17. Islam perfectly fulfills the prophetic description of the religion the Antichrist will institute and compel. It denies God the Father. It denies God the Son. It advocates beheading Christians. It aspires to be a one-world religion. Probably the most important realization is that Islam directly contradicts the central message of the Bible. Pray for those who call themselves Muslim, but have an actual hunger for the God who made them. Pray for the God of the harvest to get a believing Christian to share the gospel with them. Luke 21:36. Watch you therefore and pray always, that you may be accounted worthy to escape all these things that shall come to pass, and to stand before the Son of Man. May the Spirit of God open your eyes to the light, your ears to the truth, and your heart to His Son, the Lord Jesus Christ. Amen.